What do you know? What do you know? Le magazine anglais qui vous permet de baigner dans la langue de Shakespeare. What do you know? Une production et une réalisation de Ramatou Oyaole.
Good evening. Today, Saturday, November 4th, 2023. Join us on our discussions. In the studio over here, I'm not alone. I have my guests as usual. On my right-hand side, I have Mr. Kofi Dugbaja and Mr. Philip Ahiadoho on my extreme right. The host of the program is Ramatou Oyaole. Mr. Kofi Dugbaja, welcome to the studio of Radio Lomeng.
Hello, madam. Thank you very much for meeting you at the studio of Radio Lomeng today once again in this program. And I take this opportunity to greet all our friends, wherever they are, doing the listening. Thank you for them. We love you. We love you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
What is marriage?
Now, madam, let's come back to our program. You would like to know about marriage today. Here we are. Your first question is, what is marriage? Madam, marriage is the union. It's the union of two people. I mean, man and woman, yes, matured, of course, matured people who accept to be together for life. And from their union, children come out. So, that is a woman who accept to live with a man, both of them accept, they come together. So, that is what we call marriage. And when they accept, they are not going to stop there. There are certain things they have to perform or to do. That is that. So, as simply as possible, marriage is the union of two people who accept to live together for life. Thank you, madam.
Thanks for your explanation. Okay. What are marriage obligations?
Now, talking about marriage obligations, madam, marriage obligations, there are many. But let me talk about this first of all. What we notice in our society today is very pitiful. Pitiful because there are many, many men nowadays who take women who come to live with them, they cook with those men, they bear children with them, but never these men go to see the parents of these women who are living with them. It is pitiful. It is a way to say that marriage is not having sex with a girl or a woman and having children. That is not that. This is going to push me to say that marriage obligations are many. The first one is the payment of the dowry. Madam, if you take a woman and you don't pay the dowry, that is, you don't go to see the parent of that girl who are going to tell you, bring this, bring that, bring that, and we are going to pray for you, and we are going to leave our girl to you. If you don't do that, whenever you can bring the woman to, or how many years the girl or the woman can do with you, how many children that girl can do with you, you never marry her. This is very, very important. Our fellows, our dear listeners should know. So it is occasion for us to beg, let me say it like that, those who are in the situation, in the case, they have to perform a ceremony or they have to pay something to the girl's parents before they know that they are in marriage. And marriage obligation, it is not finished with the payment of the dowry. In my viewpoint, there are also some obligations. For instance, when you bring or when you take a woman who is bearing children for you, who is cooking for you, who is doing other duties for you, you have to protect that girl. You have to feed that girl. Clothing is very important. And you have to be faithful to that girl. You have to prove to that girl that since you tell him at the beginning of your union that you love him, you have to be faithful to that woman. And I'm not going to say that it is only these obligations are only at the side of the man. Not at all. Girls or women also have obligation toward their women. Toward, for instance, please, toward the men they say they love. That is also important.
Mr. Kofi Dugbaja, should a married woman ask her ex for financial assistance to support her husband in need?
Now to finish, madam, you are saying that should a married woman ask her ex for financial assistance to support her husband in need? Let me say categorically no. No, because it is a shame. It is a shame of both of them to say that the man I have already left for me now to go to ask him to give me money to help my second man to do this and that. It is shameful. There are certain things that we shouldn't think of until we come to do. Not at all. It is not good. It is not good. Madam, you know, if there is a woman who can do that, that woman is not going to be serious in the house at the end of the day. I'm telling you. And it is very, very, very shameful. So, madam, these are my point of view to all the questions you asked me. Thank you very much. I greet our dear listeners. Thank you very much.
Okay. Good evening, Mr. Philip Ahiadoho. I'm delighted to have you as one of our guests for our discussions of today, Saturday, November 4th, 2023. Our faithful listeners would like to know you more.
Thank you, my sister, Ramatu. My name is Philip Ahiadoho. I hail or comes from Aplau Bit 9, but currently living at Akwetia within the largest diamond mining company in West Africa. I was the headmaster of the mine school called GCDJHS for 15 years and I retired as Deputy Director of Education in 2019. Currently, I am a local representative of Akwetia Mine UK, an NGO of Akwetia citizens based in UK who are supporting basic education in Akwetia town. That is my portfolio. That is what I am doing now. So, as a retired, I am interested in reading, researching into religious issues and political issues. So that is what I do, and that is my name. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for coming to the studio of Radio Lume for our discussions. Now, my first question says, what is marriage?
When one is asked, what is marriage? What is marriage? There are many definitions that could be given to marriage. Marriage can be defined in general terms. Marriage could be defined in a specific terms. Especially in Africa, there is a way that people look at marriage. West Africa have the same. So I'll try my best to give few definition based upon my understanding. So the question posed is, what is marriage? Marriage in African traditions is a union between two families, not two individuals. That is why an engagement ceremony, which is often also a dowry payment, bride price ceremony, is very important. Those ceremonies bring together the whole family and allow each side to get to know each other. The second definition is, marriage is a divine institution because it is believed that God made man and woman to be companion, to be partners in life. It is also a social commitment or contract for comfort, companionship, enrichment, love and trust. It is a social contract for procreation and the building up of society. The third one, marriage is a mutual understanding between a man and a woman. The two people are brought together by a force of attraction and love. That force of attraction could be said is a divine plan
Why there are many women or men in the world, but that is the only one you selected as your wife or husband. Finally, marriage can be defined as the state of uniting with a person of the opposite sex as husband or wife by law or under a religious ceremony. We can also define it as a relationship between two persons living together in a consensual and mutually supportive way, especially when raising children. There are many types of marriage, but for purpose of today's discussion, we would not go into details. So let's look at the types of marriage: a civil marriage, a religious marriage, monogamous, polygamous marriages, etc.
Thank you. Hope you've heard what Mr. Kofi Dugbaja have just said. From your point of view, Mr. Philip, what are obligations of a husband in marriage? Or what are marriage obligations?
So if there is a marriage, there should be obligations. So what are marriage obligations? Marriage obligation: a comprehensive marital relationship, specifically the obligation to live together, faithfulness, respect for one another, and support for one another. Husband's obligation: the husband must be respectful to his wife, communicate openly with her, fulfill his commitment, be there for her in time of challenges, situations, be loyal, passionate, and make an effort to make the marriage work. That of the woman or the wife: the woman should shower her husband with all the love and affection, but making sure you are emotionally fulfilled and happy in the marriage is important. The woman should take care of household duties, keep the house in order, tidy and clean, respect the husband. In another way, understanding of his mood and needs. The most important thing to understand when it comes to deciphering men in this situation: the woman have the following obligations to add to the earlier one. Affection and spontaneity should not deny the man or the husband sex. Believe and support the husband. Ability and willingness to forgive the husband in case of challenges or certain things. Communicate openly with the man. Emotionally support when the man is going through emotional challenges. Share the household responsibilities. Financial obligation, that is to contribute. If the man hasn't got, or if the school fees are brought, the woman can take part. Love and affection for the man. Respect the man. These are the few things that the man and the woman are obliged to do in the marriage.
Okay. Thank you very much indeed for your explanation. Mr. Philip, should a married woman ask her ex-husband for financial assistance to support her husband in need?
The third question, I am looking at it as I am the one in difficulties, and my wife would like to seek financial assistance from her ex-husband. Personally, I would not accept it if it is brought to my knowledge, simply because it will lower me. Even though I am in challenges, I will not get involved in that. What will you mean if my wife is going for the financial assistance and it turns the other way? Secondly, it could lead to death of the man, that is me. Our tradition does not allow certain things, and we know, just like a man cannot have sex with siblings or close family relations. If it is done, there is a difficulties in that relationship. My brother cannot come to me and say, I am in difficulties, and because of that, he has the money and therefore he will like to have an affair with this thing. Africans have a taboo. Africans have do's and don't. And there are certain things that our forefathers put together. If you are not very careful, before you say Jack, you are gone. And therefore, I will not accept that financial assistance from my wife's ex-husband. If I'm not aware, maybe this thing. But why are they going to look at me? Then the woman better go back to the ex-husband. He should not be my wife again to do that. So I will not tolerate it. Simple. I will not tolerate it. But what can we say? People will try to bring in for the sake of your life. I know that death is not the end of life. I will come back by way of reincarnation and then resolve whatever issue it is. For such a thing to be done is abomination, and I will not get involved. No, I will not do it. So that is me, short. I will not get involved in such a thing to have a problem. So that is all I would like to say about that.
Mr. Philip Ahiadoho, I'm glad to have you in the studio for our discussions. Mr. Kofi Dugbaja, I'm delighted to have you on our program of today, Saturday, November 4th, 2023.
Thank you very much.
It's time for us to sign out. Thanks for keeping us in company. My thanks also goes to the technical producer. Stay tuned and enjoy the rest of our program in French. Until we come your way next week, Saturday, remain blessed.
What do you know? What do you know? Le magazine anglais qui vous permet de baigner dans la langue de Shakespeare. What do you know? Une production et une réalisation de Ramatou Oyaole.